Alex of Sabre Academy Vienna, and today I'm not here to show you some techniques of Sabre Combat, but I thought it would be beneficial to show you some tools of our trade and to do a little comparison of those tools. So when you start out with Sabre Combat, the first thing you need is a saber. A combat saber, can be as simple as a stick, physically a saber, an LED saber is nothing more than a hollow stick, and the introductory level of LED sabers are so-called stunt sabers. This one is an Ultra Saber Apprentice. It is the cheapest option you have when it comes to LED sabers. And what makes this so cheap is the lack of sound. So I switch it on. It's a flashlight with a blade. Simple, nothing more. What a stunt saber is, it consists of an LED and a battery pack. This battery pack, especially with the Ultra Sabers, is prone to disconnecting with hard hits, because the batteries are kept in place by some springs and Velcro straps. So I have added some cushion here, which makes this battery pack go in rather firmly and protects it from said vulnerability. So, this is what we call the glow stick. Because it consists of a polycarbonate blade like every other LED saber, this is a heavy grade, a normal heavy grade from Ultra Sabers with a rounded point. And you can see the light is distributed rather evenly along the whole blade, but it's silent. So, up the scale, we have another Ultra Saber. This is my customized shock. It's a consular pommel and some leather added and some engravings. So, and this is an Ultra. This is an Ultra Saber's Ultra Edge heavy grade blade. With the Ultra Edge, there is a different kind of cellophane, which distributes the light. So and this has the obsidian version of Y4 sound card. So when I switch this one on, you have sound. You see. The Ultra Edge distributes the light more evenly in the blade, so you have a fuller blade when it comes to the light impression. And as you can hear, this saber sounds like the original. For saber combat, it doesn't matter if you have sound or not. It's just a personal thing. If you want to hear the saber sound, then it's clearly more cool to have added. But it ups the price. With the version 4 of the Obsidian sound card, this rises up to about 400 euros, including tax. So, or even more, depending on the hilt design. The problem with the Ultra Sabers is we have already 7 of them, and we have three which didn't last the first year. The problem with the Ultra Sabers seems to be the battery pack, as I said in the Stunt Sabers, which is not so great a problem with the version 4 of sound card things, because they have lithium ions AccuPacks in there, which are not so prone to disconnecting with hits, but they seem to be very, very vulnerable when dropped. Another vulnerability, the switch. This is an anti-vandal kind of switch, which seems to have not so many problems, but when you see the Stunt Saver, this one is prone to breaking. And they are, as we found out, not the real hard tools they are announced to be. So, another maker. This is a Saberforge Mercenary. This is a limited model. The Saberforge saber has a real advantage over the Ultra Saber, and this is it doesn't rattle. When we have the Ultra Saber, you hear the electronics rattle inside the hilt. This is true to every Ultra Saber I have, and I have 7 of them. But in Saberforge Saber, no rattling. This is because the electronics are made to fit really firmly inside the hilt, and the LED is set with a retention screw like the blade. All of the LED sabers have a retention screw for the blade, so you can change the blade or put it away and set it firmly inside the hilt, and with another retention screw the LED is kept firm inside the hilt. A rather simple thing which Ultra Sabers just doesn't seem necessary. So this is also a Saberforge blade with a round point, more pointy, but not really a pointy end. And they propose to be the most lasting blade in the Saber in almost the Saber builds. But it is. At least in our sparring, it is the blade with the least notches and scratches, while the Ultra Sabers have clearly notches, scratches, and dents. So the Saberforge saber has a so-called kill key. So you have to
Saber Core Crimson.
You have to put the kill key away so the circuit is closed, and now you can light it up. And as you hear, there's also a sound card. That's the basic sound card from Saberforge. You have some options like the flickering of the light, like the loudness and all such things, just to do directly with the on and off button. And when you want to put it away or don't need it, you have to enter the kill key so the circuit is broken and it can't start from by accident. With Saber Forge, you have a shop that makes really unique designs, and their only drawback is they tend to have a bit sharp edges. So when you use those things in actual combat, you probably have to sand the edges a bit so you don't scratch yourself or your partner. So, and now the third maker. This is an Italian. An Italian maker. It's called Lama di Duce, which is a simple sporting design. So this is a design made for sport lightsaber combat. This is a design made for not for show, not for great design like the other sabers, but this is a tool. This is a tool for fighting. And it has some very unique things about it. First, the design, it's pure and simple. Then all the other sabers have their speaker in the pommel or behind the pommel. Lama di Duce has its speaker in the middle. You see those holes? Those are for the speaker. Then you have a very clean and neat hilt. This is a simple design which does really feel great when used in combat. And the next thing is, you see there is no on and off button. So to start this thing, you have to use gestures. And that's the catch. Because sometimes these gestures just don't work. At least for me. So you have to put it upright, you have to put it in 45 degrees angle, tap two times on the pommel, and you see, it starts up. The sound is another thing, because this is a very unique sound, like an electric guitar on a lot of distortion. But you see, even flash on flash, and to power it down, you just have to keep it horizontal for about 3 seconds, and it's powered down. So there's no button that can get broken. There is nothing to scratch yourself. The blade I inserted here is an Ultra Saber Ultra Edge Heavy Grade. I had to sand it down a bit to fit into the Lama di Duce hilt. I'll come to that in a moment. Another thing is, you have a USB port, a mini USB port here, which you can connect, by which you can connect the hilt or the electronics with a computer, and you can change the color of the blade. You have three different banks. You can change the sound, but beware, I've tried it. Even though the sound card plays wave files, not every sound is really good for the speaker. So I switched back to the original sounds because when you just change the order of the sounds played, especially the swing and the clashes, it gets a lot less annoying than the original ones. So this is the Lama di Duce, and now for the blades. As I already said, those are polycarbonate blades. This is an Ultra Saber Heavy Grade Ultra Edge. This is heavy grade because it's about 4 millimeters thick wall with a screwed and glued point, and this is what we use in our as our standard. This is an Ultra Saber's Ultra Edge mid-grade blade, which has a wall thickness of about 2 millimeters. You can see there's the paper inside, and I can put my index finger in here, not so in here. With the mid-grade blades are simply brighter when lit up. So, but the drawback is, as there is a lot less material, it's a lot more prone to breaking than the heavy grade. So, some people think they are more safe. I don't think so, because everything that breaks, and especially any plastic that breaks, does so with sharp edges. So, if a mid-grade blade breaks, it will splinter and it will have sharp edges, and sharp edges are deadly. So, even the heavy grades can break. They will break after time, but they will last a lot longer, and they are therefore, though they are heavier, though they may hit harder, they are safer because breaking is a lot less a risk than with the mid-grade blades. I know that that some clubs favor the mid-grades because they are bending and seem to be safer, but it's the same with steel. It's not the problem of the steel weight. It's the problem of the steel hardness, and the problem is breaking and not the hitting power, because hitting power can be controlled by technique, but breaking is a factor I can't control as a fighter. So this leads us right off to safety. The first thing we need our gloves. These are made by an Italian company called Gallardoni, and they provide ample protection on the fingers, on the knuckles, the thumb, and the forearm. They were initially designed for knife fighting and knife training, but they are really, really good for any kind of stick and saber. So, if you can't get your hands on one of these, these are just improved motorcycle gloves. So if you look hard enough, you'll probably find motorcycle gloves in the same league. And the next thing you will need for actual saber combat and sparring and free play is a fencing mask. A fencing mask provides not only protection of the head, but it also makes it possible to hit the head. If you don't wear anything on your head, I will not be able to safely attack your head, because I may hit you in the eyes. I may just slam my saber on your head, breaking your head, or at least drawing blood. And this is just no fun anymore. So Without any head, without any head protection, no attack on the head. The fencing mask has not only the power to stop hits from a saber, it also distributes the energy and it protects the face, so I can actually stab you in the face, I can hit across your face, it's no problem, the mesh holds up. What I have added here, because this is a HEMA, this is intended for HEMA, is a back of the head protector, which also provides cushioning on along the head, and has, as you see here, a cushioned and hardened back plate, which protects the back of my head and my neck. These two things are the most basic, the most basic protective items you will need for saber combat, as we are practicing it in Saber Academy Vienna. And you can add up as you add up the game. If you want to hit harder, you have to wear protection on your torso. If you want to hit to the legs, you will probably have to add some leg protection. But that's optional and up to you. What you really need are decent gloves and a fencing mask. That's probably enough for now. I hope you found something useful, and may the force be with you.